Here are 15 tips and tricks for Adobe Lightroom that will speed up your workflow and get you better results each and every time you edit your images. We'll look at everything from using built-in AI masking selections to unlocking hidden features inside of Lightroom and how to quickly sync edits across an entire shoot. Hi, my name is Jamie from Envato Tuts Plus, and I'm a portrait and still life photographer. I've been using Adobe Lightroom as a major part of my post-production workflow for over a decade now, and have picked up more than a few tips and tricks along the way. Let's jump into the video and get started. This first tip I'm going to give you is one you're going to want to use every single time you're importing images into Lightroom. I'm willing to bet that the way you currently import your images is to click on the Import button in the main Lightroom workspace, and then click through to track down the folder that your images are in. If so, I'm going to save you working through that clunky workspace. I'm going to use images that I've downloaded from Envato Elements, which is a great resource for any and all creative digital assets. It has millions of photos to choose from, as well as many other digital assets for photographers, such as presets, actions, and a whole lot more. Now, I'm going to locate the photos I downloaded from Elements, and then all I need to do is simply click and drag the photos into the Lightroom workspace. Lightroom will populate the import prompt window with your images. Now click Import from there, and you're off to the races. My absolute favorite way to organize images inside of a shoot is to use the starring method. After I import my images into Lightroom, I'll quickly go through each photo and tap the number 1 on my keyboard for any and all images that I like. This applies a 1-star rating to all of the good images from a shoot. Next, tap the filter button in the bottom right-hand corner and then select Rated to be filtered by, and then select 1-star. This will now only show us the images that I've applied a 1-star rating to. You can continue to refine the selection further by pressing 2 to apply a 2-star rating, and all the way up to 5 stars. Or click 0 to remove the rating and reset the image back to 0 stars. One of the features we love most about Lightroom is how quickly it can make edits. By using a setting called Match Total Exposure, I'm going to speed up your post-production workflow even more. If you have a set of images where the sun is changing throughout the shoot, or you were changing your exposure setting on your camera, your images in Lightroom will all look slightly different. Typically, you would change the exposure one by one to get them to match, but instead, set the correct exposure for just one image. Next, hold down Shift and click to the end of the set of images that you want to match. Then, go to Settings, Match Total Exposure, and it will correctly adjust every image's exposure setting to match the tonal value of your first image, saving you a ton of editing time. While the Lightroom workspace is incredible, it is busy and has a lot of different things that pull your attention away from the actual photo itself. While moving through a photo edit, it can be extremely useful to hide all of that clutter, so you can consider the photo and the edits that you've made. There are two really quick and easy ways to do this. The first is the Lights Out option. Tap L on your keyboard and Lightroom will dim the workspace while keeping your photo front and center. Tap L one more time and Lightroom will fully black out the workspace. Tap L a third time to return back to normal. The second way to approach this is to use the full screen option. Tap the letter F on your keyboard and Lightroom will make your image full screen while also dimming the background. Tap F again to return back to the workspace. Using virtual copies is a really great way to try out different editing styles on a single image and then be able to quickly and easily compare the different versions. Creating a virtual copy of an image is really simple. Just select the image or images that you want to duplicate and hold Control and click on the thumbnail. Then select Create Virtual Copy. Now you'll have two versions in your menu, with the virtual copy thumbnail displaying as a little folded over corner. I like to use virtual copies to be able to experiment with editing styles, while also chasing a more traditional edit for my style. Similarly, it can be a really useful tool if you want to create both a color and black and white edit of the same image. Using a virtual copy, you can make the black and white conversion, and then have both options ready to go in your Lightroom workspace. One of the best and easiest ways to quickly check your work as you're moving through an edit in Lightroom is to use the before and after toggle. When you're in the Develop module, all you need to do is tap the backslash key on your keyboard, and Lightroom will display the image as it was originally imported into Lightroom, without any of your edits. Tap the backslash again, and you'll return to your edited version. This can be a huge help to check the original colors of an image, or just as a check-in to see how much or how little you've edited your image. Getting a neutral white balance is key to getting accurate colors in your image. We all know you can set a white balance by using the Lightroom white balance presets or by manually dragging the temperature and or tint sliders. But did you know about this eyedropper tool? Located in the top left of the white balance menu is the Lightroom eyedropper tool. Click the eyedropper to select it and move your cursor to a neutral part of your image, meaning where the RGB values are nearly the same. Lightroom will show you an overlay of the RGB values as you move your mouse around. A good place to find neutral values can be something gray in the image, like clothing or cement on the ground, or try something white like the subject's teeth or eyes. Once the RGB values are closely aligned, click that spot and Lightroom will set the white balance based on that point. You can always click the eyedropper again and click another area to try a different neutral sampling point. The HSL color menu is very intuitive with its individual sliders for each color, but sometimes it can be difficult to tell the difference between similar tones, such as blue and aqua or orange and red. Rather than guess, if you click the little target beside either hue or saturation or luminance, then go over to the area in your image that you're wanting to affect, click to slide up or down, which will increase or decrease those specific color values. This will affect any and all color values associated with that section of the image that you're choosing. Repeat this as many times as needed and watch as the values change. The Option key on a Mac or Alt on a PC has a whole layer of hidden features that most Lightroom users don't know about. My favorite hidden feature is its function in the Sharpening tab as it relates to masking. Masking controls what part of the image is having the sharpening applied to, but it can be really difficult to see what is or isn't being affected. If you hold down the Option key and drag the masking slider, you'll see a black and white preview of the image appear, where the white represents the portion of the image that's going to be sharpened. This is so handy. Another great hidden use of the Option key is as a clipping visualizer. If you hold down the Option key and drag the exposure or white sliders, Lightroom will only display any values that are clipping, so as I drag the sliders up, you'll notice that the clipping alerts appear. This is really helpful to make sure you're not blowing out any highlights anywhere. Cropping your image is an often essential part of a photo edit, and Lightroom has a whole number of grid overlays that can help you get way more accuracy when you're making your crops. When you click the Crop and Straighten button in the Develop module, it'll bring up a crop overlay on top of your image. This is what helps you preview the section that will remain and what section will be cropped out. The default overlay gives you a rule of thirds overlay, which is a great starting place, but by simply tapping the letter O, you'll be able to cycle through a number of different overlays. I particularly like the overlay that has the different crop ratios all in one, so I can easily visualize a crop for Instagram or for print. Be sure to cycle through these and try them out if you're looking to try out some new crops. One of my favorite tools inside of Lightroom, and in my opinion, an absolute must for every photo edit, is found in the Lens Correction menu, and it's the Enable Profile Corrections button. One tap of this button, and Lightroom will auto-detect the camera and lens that were used to make the image, and then provide corrections for lens distortion and vignetting for that specific combination of camera and lens. Depending on the camera and lens that you used, this could have either a major or minor change on your image, but I highly recommend integrating this into your editing workflow. Lightroom has some newer AI masking features that can really help speed up a workflow. By far and away my favorite of these tools is the Select Subject Mask. In the Develop module, click the Masking shortcut above the Basics menu, then Create New Mask and Select Subject. Lightroom will quickly analyze your image and mask out just the subject. The subject will appear with a red overlay, showing the area that's been masked out. Now, you can make any and all edits to this mask, and only your subject will be affected. This is extremely useful and is a huge time save in your post-production workflow. Whether you're working with the built-in Lightroom presets, or you've created your own custom user presets, did you know that you can affect the amount of that preset that is applied? Tucked in just above the presets menu is an amount slider. It will be grayed out until you apply a preset. Once you've applied a preset, it'll display a slider range from 0 to 200. By default, every preset is applied at 100%, but by using this amount slider, you can customize how much of the preset you want, sliding it all the way up to 200% to double the intensity, or back it anywhere back down below 100 if you want the adjustments off. Perhaps the best feature in all of Lightroom is its ability to quickly edit numerous images at once. If you have a set of images that were shot at a similar time with similar light and similar camera settings, then syncing your Lightroom settings is going to be a gigantic time saver. Go ahead and make your edits to only one of the images in the set. Then press Command-C to bring up the Copy Settings box. Tap Check All to copy all of the editing parameters that you made in your original image. Then click Copy. Now, shift and click to the end of the photos in your Lightroom set, and then tap the Sync button at the bottom of the workspace. Tap Synchronize, and just like that, all of the edits that you made to your original image are now applied to every image in the set. The last tip I'm going to share with you is the quickest way to export your finished images so you can easily post them to Instagram or send them in an email. First, select the image or group of images that you want to export. Then go to File, Export, to bring up the Lightroom export window. After you've chosen your desired exporting folder and done any necessary file renaming, scroll down a little bit more to the File Settings and Image Sizing menus. In File Settings, be sure to select JPEG from the drop-down menu. Then, in the Image Sizing menu, tick the Resize to Fit box and then select Long Edge from the drop-down menu. Instagram's maximum size is 1,080 pixels wide, so let's set the long edge size to 1,080 pixels. Now click Export, and you'll have perfectly sized web resolution photos ready to go. You've made it to the end of my list of top 15 tips and tricks that all Adobe Lightroom users should know. I hope at least a few of these tips have been helpful for you to see a better or quicker way to edit your images inside of Lightroom. We've got a ton of other Lightroom and Photoshop tutorials on the Envato Tuts Plus YouTube channel, so be sure to give this video a like and subscribe to the channel for more photo editing tutorials.